Now, I'm really excited for this one because Blood Angels are one of my favourite Space Marine chapters, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint their really striking colour scheme. Now, I'm actually going to show you two methods for painting the main part of them, which is their power armour. I'm first going to show you how to do it using a layer paint, then I'm going to show you how to do it using a dry paint. Now, at the end of that, you can choose whichever you like most and use that one. Now, even though I'm going to be painting a Space Marine from a tactical squad, all the methods and techniques I'm going to show you will be useful for you for painting all sorts of Space Marine armour. So not just for Blood Angels, but also the different squad types. So whether you're painting Terminators or even scouts, you're going to find something useful in this video. So let's get started. Now, the first thing that I've done with my miniature is undercoat it with Chaos Black Spray, and I always recommend that you give your miniature an undercoat before you start painting it. That's because it will give you a really nice surface to paint on, and also will help the paint stick to your miniature. Now, in the intro I mentioned that I was going to show you two different methods for how to paint the power armour in a Space Marine, and I do recommend you start with the power armour because it's really the main part of it. Now, the first of these methods I'm going to show you is how to use layer paints for it, and the first stage to do this is to start with a base coat. Now, the colour you need for this is Mephiston Red, and as always, give the paints a good shake before you start to use each one. Now, because I'm also going to be painting so much of the model with this colour, I'm going to be applying this using a large brush. So get some loaded onto your brush and then put it onto your palette. And then I'm going to add a bit of water to it, not very much, just a small amount mixed in like that. This will help smooth the paint down, so when it dries, it'll be smoother on the miniature and give you a nicer finish. Also, using a palette like this means I can control how much paint's on the brush. And, well, this way you can really avoid putting on too much paint at once. If you do, you see, you can start to clog detail. But doing it like this means you can avoid that happening. So for the first stage, I'm just going to be painting this colour all over the miniature, and I'm really looking to work it into all the little details all across him, so just take your time with it. Now, you may find as you're doing this, some of the black undercoat still shows through that red. Now, that's not a problem if that happens. Wait till this coat dries, then just apply a second coat afterwards and you'll see all that black will disappear. This is because it's always best to apply multiple thin coats than one thick coat, because that way you avoid clogging up all the detail. If you did one thick coat, well, you can make a bit of a mess of your miniature that way. So take your time with it, apply thin coats, and once you've done this base coat, we'll move on to the next step. It's taken me two coats, but you can see now I've got a really bright, strong red, which is perfect for the next stage, which is to add a shade to the armour. Now for this, the colour you need is Agrax Earthshade, and I'm going to apply it using a fine detail brush because, well, you need to be precise with this part. So I'm going to use my palette again to control how much paint's on the brush, and I'm going to just twist my brush and drag it along like that, just to help bring the bristles to a nice point, which will give me lots of control for this next stage. Because what you're looking to do is to paint this colour into all the recessed parts, all these lines on his armour. So if I just do around his face, you see I'm just going to follow all those little corners running around there like that. And this will really help define all that detail. Now when you're doing this, it's, well, pretty much inevitable at some point that some of the paint will smudge or you'll make a mistake and get it somewhere where you don't want it. It is going to happen on mine at some point. When that does happen, just let the shade dry, then neaten up afterwards with some more Mephiston Red. And you're best to stick with your fine detail brush to do that. Now the shade is dry, you can see it's really defined all the panels on the armour. And well, now it's done, we're ready to add a highlight to it. Now, the technique I'm going to use for this is called edge highlighting, and the colour you need is Evil Sun Scarlet. And doing this really is all about brush control, so you need a fine detail brush for it, and when you get your paint ready on your palette, thin it down so that the paint flows smoothly and easily from your brush. And you'll be able to tell that by just running your brush along the palette. Now, what you need to do is just twist your brush and drag it along to get the bristles to a nice tip. And then using this, you just need to go around all the edges on the armour. So if I start up on the head again, what I'm looking to do is look for any of these sharp edges, like on this kind of vent on the top here, and I'm just going to paint a line following the edge of it all the way around like that. And doing this gives a really nice effect to finish off the power armour. So what you need to do now is go around your miniature doing this on all of the areas all around him, and it will take a bit of time, but that's okay because once this is done, there's really only a few more details left to do on the miniature. So now I've finished doing the edge highlight on the power armour, you can see it's given a really nice effect to it. And, well, it is quite subtle, but as we add more colours to the miniature, it's going to really help define that armour more and more. So now with that done, if you remember back to the intro, I told you I was going to show you an alternate way of how to highlight power armour. And that method's called dry brushing. Now to do this, on your Space Marine, you need to first of all base coat the model with Mephiston Red. So this is done in exactly the same way as we did with the previous version. And once you got to this stage, the colour you need to get hold of is Kindle Flame. And you need to do this with a medium dry brush. And it is important to use a dry brush for this because the bristles are stiffer than on a normal brush. And you need that for this technique to work. So what you do is just get a little bit of this paint loaded on the tip of your brush. And we'll get some tissue and just start working this paint into that tissue like that, and working the paint in amongst the bristles. Now it's important here that you don't have very much paint left on your brush. So as you can see, I am getting rid of most of it. And before you start painting on your model, you want your brush to be looking something like that. So what you do is get your Space Marine and you're looking to start flicking this against all the sharper edges on the armour in particular. So around the helmet here, for example, I'm going to start going across those parts like that. And you'll see this orange starts catching on the edges around there like that. Now on Space Marines, there are quite a lot of rounded panels too. So when you get to areas like that, like this shoulder pad, for example, just aim it more towards the areas where the light would land on it, straight down on top of the miniature. So what I'm going to do is start rubbing this paint across it like that. And you'll see, because I've got not much paint on the brush, it very smoothly starts to highlight the colour there. Now this orange is going to look a little bit weird on this red straight away at first at the stage, but that's okay, because in the next stage we're going to bring these two colours together. Once you finish the dry brushing, your model should look something like this. And well, the next stage is to bring these colours together. And to do that, I'm going to be applying a shade across the whole model. Now, the colour to use is Carraberg Crimson, and I'm going to be applying this using my wash brush because I'm going to be putting on so much of it. And what I'm going to do is load my brush up with plenty and put some on the palette. Got some on the side of the brush there. There we are, get some plenty loaded up on your brush. And well, then you start applying this across the whole miniature. So I'm just going to start slapping this on all over it, making sure that I really work it into all the little details. And you can see immediately it makes a massive difference to the model. Now, whilst you do need to put a lot of this on, you do need to make sure that you don't go crazy, because if it's dripping off the model, well, you definitely put on too much. Make sure you don't get any large blobs or anything forming, especially towards the bottom of the miniature. So just keep an eye on it as it dries. Now, because you put on so much shade, this will take quite a bit of time to dry, anything up to 45 minutes really, and you need to make sure it's completely dry before you move on to the next step. So there we go. Now the shade's dry, you can see we've got a really nice effect on the armour. I think it looks really cool. And well, now that's done, I'm going to move back to the other Space Marine to continue the rest of this tutorial to finish the model off. But I am going to be painting both these models from now on in exactly the same way at the same time. And you'll see both of them at the end in a comparison side by side. Now the first area we're going to paint now will be the silver parts. And for this you need three colours. We'll start with a base coat of Lead Belcher, then shade over these parts in non-oil, and then finally add a highlight using Runefang Steel. And for most of this, I'm going to be using a standard brush to apply this paint. But I do have a fine detail brush as well, and that's for the smaller areas. Things like on the face, the mouthpiece, and the pipes in there as well. So for the first step, with Lead Belcher, you're looking to apply as even a base coat as you can over all the parts you want to be silver. And there are quite a few of them. If you're not sure which bits to do, I recommend you just look at the box art, and that will guide you through which parts to do like this. But I'm going to start on his bolt gun. And well, it's just a case of painting these parts silver. Now, you don't really need to worry about the areas that aren't going to be silver, like the casing, for example. We're going to paint those parts later anyway, but you just need to be neat when you're getting close to that armour. Just be careful around those parts. The next stage is to apply a shade of non-oil all over these silver parts, and I'm using a standard brush only to do this. And once again, just be careful whenever you're going near the red armour plates that you don't get this shade onto those. And then to finish the silver, just use your fine detail brush to add a highlight of Runefang Steel following all the edges of these silver parts. So this is an edge highlight really, just like when we were doing the red power armour earlier. And there we go, with that highlight done, the silver's finished and we can start the next part. And that's going to be to paint the black areas of his armour. Now for this you only need two colours. We're going to start with a base coat of Abaddon Black and then add a highlight using Eshin Grey. And for this first step with the Abaddon Black, I'm going to be using both my standard and my fine detail brush. And this is, well, just like with the silver, I'm going to use the fine detail brush for all the smaller areas, but the standard brush for most of it. So you just need to get your paint ready once again. Thin down with a bit of water and make sure you don't have too much on your brush. So there we go. And well, there's quite a few areas on the model that you need to paint with this. And if you're not sure which bits to do, once again, just check your box art and that will guide you through it. So I'm going to start with this, these wings on this chest here. And you just need to be as neat as you can whenever you're getting towards those other areas of colour. So whenever you're getting near the red or the silver, just really take your time with those parts. And then use your fine detail brush to add a highlight of Eshin Grey, following along all the raised parts of the black. And with that highlight done, the black is now finished, and we're ready to move on to the next detail, and this is going to be all the gold. Now for this you need four colours. We'll start with a base coat of Balthazar gold this time, then shade over these areas using Agrax Earthshade. After that I'm going to layer using Gehenna's gold, and this will give a very bright and shiny appearance. Ready for the final step, which is a highlight of Runefang Steel. So I'm going to be using my same two brushes once again, my standard and my fine detail, and starting with Balthazar gold, you're just looking to base coat all the areas that you want to be gold, and I'm going to go for all the little trinkets and designs on his armour for this. So there's quite a large one on his backpack, so I'll show you on that. For this first step, you're just looking to base coat these areas with this colour, just being as neat as you can around all those other colours around it. Once you finish the base coat, apply Agrax Earthshade over these gold areas, and well, you really don't need to put very much on here, because you need to be careful that you don't lose control of it and get it on the red. When the shade's fully dry, layer with Gehenna's gold using your fine detail brush, and well, to do this, what you're looking to do is to paint this colour over most of these gold areas, just leaving the deeper areas where the shade is settled with a darker colour showing. Now take your time on this because, well, it's best to be as neat as possible for it. You can see it gives a really nice shiny effect. Really take your time on it. And then finally, use your fine detail brush to add a highlight of Runefang Steel along all the edges of the gold, and this will give you a really shiny finish. And there we go, with that highlight, the gold is finished, and well, there's not actually that much more left to do with the miniature. The next detail we're going to concentrate on are the purity seals, and also there'll be a couple of other little details we'll do at the same time with this part. And you're going to need five colours. First of all, we're going to base coat with Screamer Pink and also Xandri Dust. Then I'm going to shade over both these areas using Agrax Earthshade, then finally highlight with Pink Horror and a Shabti Bone. So to start out with Screamer Pink, this is for the actual wax seals. So I'm using my fine detail brush throughout this process because, well, these parts are quite small. Just need to get your paint ready once again, thinned with a little bit of water. And, well, the amount of these seals you'll have in your miniature will vary quite a lot depending on exactly how you put yours together. But for all of them, you just need to paint all that wax seal completely. Next, base coat the parchment using Xandri Dust. Now, when you're doing this stage, there's also a couple of other areas to base coat with Xandri Dust too. And those are some shoulder pads will have a kind of, parchment running along underneath the chapter badge too. And also, some of them will have some rope wrapped around them, such as on the arm and my model here. And you need to base coat these parts at the same time. Then, apply Agrax Earthshade over both of these colours. And once again, just be careful whenever you're getting close to the red. When the shade's completely dry, add a highlight of Pink Horror onto these seals here. And all you need to do is paint around the edges of them, just like that, around the corners. And on ones where there's a skull in the middle, what I do is just paint a small amount in the middle, just like that, just to pick out that skull. And lastly, just finish the parchment off using a bit of a Shabti Bone with your fine detail brush still. And what I do for the paper here is just to paint lines running along it, just leaving the darker bits showing in the recessed parts. And doing this, you see, really accentuates all the folds in the paper, like that. Now for the rope, on the other hand, what you need to do is just paint the most raised parts of it, leaving the shade in the deeper areas. So you're really looking at painting little lines just running along the rope, just like that. And with that last highlight of a Shabti Bone done, all the parchment and all the decorative details too are now finished. And all that's left to do is to paint the model's eyes. Now with Space Marines, whatever chapter you're doing, it's always a good idea to pick an eye colour that complements the armour well. So if Blood Angel's doing red eyes, you really wouldn't see it. But if I did green eyes, which is what I'm going to do, they'll stand out really nicely. And this is true for all Space Marine chapters. So with Ultramarines, for example, doing red eyes works really well. Now no matter what colour you're going for this, it's always best to start out with White Scar. And once you've done that, pick a glaze of the colour that you want it to be. So in my case, it's going to be Waywatcher Green. So for the first step, using White Scar, you need your fine detail brush, and, well, this step's really all about brush control. So get your paint ready for that by thinning it down in your palette with a bit of water so that the paint flows easily. And then make sure you don't have very much on your brush and that you've got a really nice fine tip on there. So just get that ready. And then what you're looking to do is to paint a line as neatly as you can in the centre of the eye. So brace your model as best you can and then just paint a small amount just down the centre, like that. Next, paint a small amount of Waywatcher Green into the whole of the recess of the eye, just like that. Not too much, but you'll see it'll give you a really nice glowing green effect. Now, if you've built some of your Space Marines without helmets on, then check out our tutorial for painting Space Wolf Grey Hunters, because in that, we show you how to paint human skin and hair as well. So there you go, both Space Marines are finished and, well, I think they're looking really cool. As you can see, there is a difference in the appearance of both of them, so whichever method you go for your army, I recommend you stick to that technique for the entire force, just for the sake of consistency. So when you're painting Space Marines, I always recommend that you do the power armour first. It is the largest part of the miniature and the most distinctive part too, so it's always a good idea to begin with that. If you go for the edge highlighting method, then, well, this really is all about having a steady hand and, well, taking your time, really. So I recommend you practice with that technique if you're going for that. If you decide to do dry brushing, though, this is all about applying the paint in moderation and gradually building it up until you get to a point that you're happy with. But no matter which method you go for, the trick really is to be as neat as you can. The neater you are, the better the final result's going to be. Now, all the methods and techniques I've shown in this video will be useful no matter what Space Marine chapter you're painting. You just need to swap out the colours. And if you want some more advice on doing that, then check out White Dwarf or go into your local Games Workshop store and the staff there will give you advice on what colours to go for. Now, I really hope you've enjoyed this video. It's been lots of fun to do, so we'll see you next time.